Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to another Dr. Petrol video. You find me in what is probably the most luxurious seat in any car in the market. Because today, we're taking a look at the Mercedes Maybach Pullman S600. But before we get into more details, these seats are so comfortable, I think I'm going to just take a quick nap here, and I'll catch up with you a bit later on. The Pullman name finds its origin in train coach building. The American entrepreneur George Pullman introduced a train sleeping car in 1868, and it was so revolutionary that the concept of luxury and spaciousness was quickly transferred to the automotive sector. Then, in 1963, after decades of building luxury limousines, Mercedes adapted the term Pullman for their cars. The Mercedes Pullman proved hugely popular with celebrities and state leaders. Drake, John Lennon, Elvis Presley, those are amongst the ones who chose to be driven around in a Mercedes Pullman. However, the Pullman also proved popular with a slightly sketchier clientele. Fidel Castro of Cuba, Kim Jong-un of North Korea, but also Pablo Escobar were driven around in Mercedes Pullmans. At 6.5 meters of length, this is the longest model in the S-Class family. And it is not your standard S-Class. It starts life out as a standard S-Class, is shipped to Brabus, and Brabus cuts it in half, puts an extra piece of length in there, and then ships it back to Mercedes-Benz. And why is that? Because of standardization. This car is only made to order. So therefore, Mercedes doesn't have its own production line for this car, because the production cost would be way too high. So therefore, Brabus, being specialized in coach builds for Mercedes, builds this car for Mercedes-Benz. You may have noticed this orange light down here in the middle of the car. That is because this car is over 6 meters in length. Cars that are longer than 6 meters need this little light in the middle to indicate to other road users that this is an exceptionally long car. And when the daylights are on the car, this light is on as well. At 6.5 meters of length, the Pullman is a full meter longer than a Maybach. And the Maybach is already 20 centimeters longer than a regular S-Class. But numbers are just numbers. So let's pull up a few cars to see how big this car actually is. And here, you have an average Golf, which fits right in the wheelbase of the whole Pullman. It's a very average car, but it fits within the wheelbase of the Pullman. That's incredible. And here we have the Aventador Super Veloce. A little less of an average car, but still much smaller than the Maybach. The Pullman is the king of length, the king of luxury. Now you may have noticed this little round here, this little circle. And these are actually the entrances for the flagpoles. And that's where these Mercedes-Benz branded pouches come in, because in here you find the actual flagpoles. These go in here, and then you can just put your family flag on there, your country flag. If you're the dictator of North Korea, you can just put the North Korean flag on there. Perfect. The Pullman has the same specifications as the Mercedes-Benz S600. That is a bi-turbo V12 with 530 horsepower, 830 newton meters of torque, and there are officially no 0 to 100 kilometers an hour times, but let's not pretend that is what this car is made for. It is made to transport its passengers in an oasis of luxury. So let's move inside and take a look at all the creature comforts and tech in there. In here, it provides space for, and I'm quoting Mercedes here, a generously sized and tastefully appointed club lounge in the rear. A club lounge in the back of a car. Ah, those automotive marketeers and their words. As is typical for the Pullman, four passengers can sit opposite each other in the compartment, with the two rear-facing seats being folding seats. So if you're in here on your own or you're just with two people, you can easily fold the front seats up and lie down. The back of the front-facing seats fold down as far as 43.5 degrees for maximal comfort. Another typical feature of the Pullman is the electrically operated partition that at the press of a button becomes blurred, so you're completely separated from the driver. The driver's compartment is fitted with a functionality called voice amplification, which, as the name suggests, amplifies the driver's voice towards the back compartment. I must say, as a driver, it is a pretty nice place to be. You got leather all around, you got this beautiful big steering wheel in front of you. Obviously, you have the V12 under your right foot, but it is a little bit snug. Obviously, you have the partition right behind the driver's seat here, so that means the seat can't go any further backwards than this. I'm 1.9 meters, and this is, well, I'd say it's plenty of space, but I shouldn't be any taller than this. So whenever you're buying this car, don't hire a too tall shower.
Naturally, the two seats in front are both heated and cooled. However, there's one extra button on the driver's side door that says R. Activating it means you can control the heat and cooling controls of the passenger seat. In the settings menu up front, you can also adjust the ambient light color. It's funny that even though this is a German car and the menu is in German, the seven different colors are still given fancy English names like Dawn Red, which is actually just pink. Let's continue with the rear area though. The first thing you notice when you step inside is just how far away the door is from the seat. The Pullman doesn't have electrically closing doors like the Rolls-Royce, so a chauffeur sure comes in handy when you want to get into your seat comfortably in the Pullman. Once the door is closed, you find all the usual Mercedes seat controls on there, as well as three-way adjustable heat and cooling options. But the seats aren't the only cooled or heated elements in this car. The cup holders in the center console in the rear are actually heated or cooled as well. The blue light indicates your drinks are being cooled, and the red light indicates the drinks are being heated. Between the two rear-facing seats, you find the controls for the climate control on a clever display that is only visible when the climate controls are turned on. On the bottom of the rear-facing seats, you find two screens. These are used for all other controls, like for instance the hot stone massage functionality of the seats. This being a new car, the remote control for these screens was still in a box, so you have to take my word for it being true. The floor mats were also still in this packaging, but I just had to show these as they're made from real sheepskin and probably the softest material I've ever felt. For maximum privacy in the rear, you can completely shut yourself off from the outside world at the press of a button. Every single window in the back can be covered with a black light blocking curtain, so you can optimally immerse yourself in the oasis of luxury of the Pullman while breathing in the scent of the Maybach Agarwood interior perfume. Yes, this car has a system that disperses a perfume through the climate control vents. For further comfort and travel enjoyment, the rear quarters are fitted with a beautiful Burmeister sound system, so you can listen to a concert of Beethoven as if you were there, whilst you read your morning newspaper on one of two folding tables that easily pop up from the center console in between the two rear seats. And when you're done with your newspaper, you can go and watch television on the 18.5-inch screen that pops up out of nowhere at the press of a button. Whereas the facelifted Maybach allows you to watch the road ahead on this screen, this one didn't have that functionality yet. However, with these beautiful meters on the ceiling, you can keep track of the speed your chauffeur is doing, the current time, or the temperature. Last but not least, this Pullman is fitted with a little champagne cooler for when you've closed another deal successfully. It also comes with two special champagne glasses for the ultimate celebration of luxury.
So, that was it for this video. I hope you liked it. I hope you had a bit of insight in how crazy luxury the Maybach is. This Pullman is super special. Thanks so much to VDM Cars for making this possible. Check them out, they have an amazing inventory of cars. Like this video, subscribe for more videos to come in the future, and I'll catch you at the next video.